Hey folks, welcome back to my next video, and in this video we're going to look at how to add motion to both tires and wheels. So let's take a look. For frequent updates, please subscribe to my channel with the link below. And be sure to follow me on Instagram at TomEnglandPhoto. Alright folks, welcome back. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at a technique used to add motion to both the tire and the wheel itself, which you have to do pretty much separately. Now we're going to work on a couple wheels here, but we're only going to go completely through one wheel. So the process for the other wheels in the car is pretty much duplicated. So with that, we're just going to go through, show you the techniques on one wheel, how to duplicate the actual selection you have to a new one, and of course show you the technique through from beginning to end on how to create motion with the wheels and tires. So a couple things with this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to eliminate the rotor holes. It's cross-drilled, and I want to eliminate those. And reason being, it's just because of the motion. With the rotation, they wouldn't really be visible if it was rotating, and it's just easier to take out and take it out now because I want the rotor to be visible, but I don't want those particular holes to be visible as well. All right, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a new layer, and it's going to be a copy of the background layer. And we're going to go down to the blur gallery and select spin blur. Now with this selection here, we're going to move the middle of this to pretty much the middle of the wheel is where we're going to want that to be. And with the selections on the left and right, as well as the top and bottom, you can simply drag the corners and we're going to make a selection around the wheel, around the wheel itself. So that looks pretty good so far. Now we can adjust the blur angle, which is on the right here. But with that, what we want to do is we don't want to create too fast. We don't want it too slow. We just want a little motion to that. And of course, that has to do with your photo. Depending on how quick the car you want moving in your photo, you will adjust this to your liking. Now we can move the middle portion around if we want to. But as soon as we make the selection, we'll take the middle and we'll just drag this to the very center of the wheel itself. And to copy the selection on Windows, we'll hold Control and Alt and click and drag, or Command and Option on a Mac and click and drag it over to the second wheel or even the third wheel, depending on how many wheels you hope to blur here. So with this particular example, we're only working on the left side of the car. The right side, which is the rear wheel, would need some of the same techniques on it, but for the purpose of this, I'll just leave that out. Just be sure of the technique that you're seeing here. Simply duplicate it over and do the same thing on each wheel that you're hoping to create a blur on. Now with this here, we're going to create a mask on this. And reason being is that with wheels, yes, they would rotate, but the actual the brake calipers themselves would not. So we're creating a mask and we're just painting over this just to show a little visibility. And this here with the AMG logo on it, we're just going to paint with a black brush on the portions to bring out the wheel itself. So here on the front wheel, we're just going over the caliper itself, and we'll just paint in some portions to make sure they're visible through the blur of the wheel itself. And when we create this, you'll see that on the round wheel itself, with the portion of the car here, it does bleed over onto that. So what I'm doing is making a selection around that. We'll feather the selection, just 0.2 is fine, and we're just going to paint away on the mask here with a black brush and just paint away the portion we don't want any blur to at all. We'll deselect that. That looks good so far. So the wheels are pretty much done. Now the treads itself, obviously they are not moving, so we have to create a new technique for those. We're going to create a new copy of the background layer and use the pen tool and just trace around the corners here and make a nice selection for just the tread of the tire itself. So we'll go up. When we get to the wheel here, just continue up like the wheel was visible, because we can mask this out later. And we'll go around and we'll connect that. Right click to make a selection on this. And 0.2 is fine. We're going to go down to filter, the blur gallery. And for this one, we'll use the path blur. And what we got to do is we just click and make a selection here of the motion of what the tread would be. So this is pretty simple. Just click until you get to the end. And then when you have a nice selection here, just push enter. And again, this is something you can adjust the speed here on the right, but just make it so it looks consistent with the speed of the wheel itself. And the tread is a lot easier to get in terms of motion than the wheel. With the tread, it's quite simple. There's a good variance of speeds you can have with this one here. And the same thing, we will select around the car, just the back portion of the car here. And this is to mask out what we did with the path blur. Make a selection, same as usual. And we will paint over this here. All right, so we'll take a look around. That looks, oh, there's a little mistake here on the top. So what I wanna do, I just wanna get rid of that little bump there in the tire. So we'll just quickly make another selection around this. Very quick. And that's good. And same thing, we'll just go onto the mask and just paint this little portion away. Give it a little, the tire, make sure it's round. Now looking at this example of the GLA, you'll see that there is a reflection. You see it often with wheels in motion. It's a reflection that doesn't necessarily come out when you use your own technique to put that in. So we're gonna create these using, we're just gonna create a selection here. We'll drag up and we will go to the adjustments, and with the curves adjustment, we'll take this up. And we're gonna blur, Gaussian blur. And we'll adjust this, 9 or 10 should be fine. And then we can use the levels here for the curves, and we can just drag this up to create a little more light on that portion. And we'll just do the same thing down here. This isn't necessary, but it does add a little bit to the realism of the motion of the wheel. And select that, same thing. We'll go to curves adjustment and we'll bring up the exposure here on that. Gaussian blur to finish it off. That's with and without. And we'll merge everything there. And of course with the front wheel, you will do the same there. Now on this wheel here, you'll see there's the center cap there, and that's with the design of the wheel and how thick it is in portions and not in others, that it's a little darker in the center. Now it looks good as is, but if we wanted to add this, we can just create a selection around here. And same thing with the curves adjustment. We're gonna create one, but we're just gonna drag this down. And that's our first step with that. Yeah, we're gonna adjust the saturation of this here just to take some of this color out of this. So blur, Gaussian blur, same thing. And then we're gonna create a hue saturation layer and make sure it only affects the layer beneath it, not every layer. Just the curves layer is all we want to adjust on this. And we'll just take the saturation down. And as a final step here, I'm going to mask out just the center. I want the center cap there to be a different exposure, a little brighter, and we'll just paint over that. And that's it. That's a technique on how you create motion in both tires and wheels. So thanks again for watching the video, and I'll see you again in the next one.